Seems like I'm back. Sorry for the delay, everyone. I was having some technical issues. Thankfully, they were all fixed. I will handle those after the stream anyway. For now, we are going to watch the match of our friends from VAL that was changed to mZu by the system due to the fact of them being in a merge during the match against XXX. It's now IKJ. Currently, it seems like VAL is ahead by 40,000 points. Seems that they are kind of dominating all the buildings that are in, or at least fighting back to reset the buildings that is possible. It's gonna be an interesting match. My bets are probably gonna be in the VAL team, but we'll see what's going to happen. We are getting a retransmission from them, so be a little bit patient in case things end up hanging or crashing a little bit. You're welcome to chat if you want to. That being said, we are going to focus in the match for now. Seems like they are holding one of the most important buildings right now, which is Solar Power Station, and not only holding, but controlling it. They just turned back a few of the buildings. This is phase one. This is one of the most important phases to set the tone of the match, where you are actually measuring your power against your opponents. So what you want to do in the buildings that you're fighting for is that you want to hold those buildings, and if you can't hold them, you at least keep flipping them so the opponent doesn't get points. This way, not only you are actually trying to get your points from your team, but you're denying points from the opponent. So, currently it seems like VAL has been very efficient in flipping the buildings that the other team was controlling, and as they have Solar Power Station, it takes a lot less time for them to hold the building, which puts a lot more pressure in the other team. We're gonna see how they're gonna perform here right now, and if they are going to be able to bounce the incoming players or not. It's 35 seconds for the control treatment center 1. There are a few marches and rallies incoming, but seems like none, at least for this building, they're going to be able to flip it. So I do think that water treatment center 1 is theirs. One thing that not everyone knows is that not only the first control, every single actual control gives you score. So every time that they're able to control like they are here, they put their advantage even further ahead than normally. For now, it seems like the match is kind of one-sided. We're gonna see how it's gonna develop, just in case. Looks like they were able to control the building, but it was actually flipped. So right now what we are going to see here is that we are going to... to see how they're gonna act in here in this position. I do think that as they're using Schneiser, which is, if I'm not mistaken, one of their top rallies, that they're probably gonna be able to bounce them off, but... And as they have to take 2 minutes to control the building, it's a lot of pressure to hold. Right now we are at the view of one of their players, that is Casper. He's one of their joiners, but it seems like he is one of the teams that is putting a lot of pressure. Looks like they were able to flip the building. This is actually bad. Not for VAL, this is actually bad for XSX. The reason that this is bad is that they're not being able to control the buildings. And as they're not able to control the buildings and Val controls the solar power station, this puts them even farther behind. Even if they can get some of the water that are on the top of the buildings by this, the amount of points that they lose just by not being able to control the buildings, it's not worth it. Now that the center open, a lot of the forces between the alliances are going to be spread out more thin, and you're going to be seeing how XXX is going to react, because this puts a lot more pressure on the red leads, and now it starts to become a little bit more about movement. We're going to see also how Val is going to react in the building in the top right, if they're going to keep putting pressure and flipping it, or if they're going to let it go in terms of controlling it there. Knowing Val, as they tend to actually want to take everything, I assume that they're at least going to send one or two rallies to flip it. I may be wrong, because as far as I heard, hey, there you go! They just flipped the building. And that is what usually they try to do. They try to contest every single building, even if they can't hold it, just to be able to not let the opponent score. The biggest advantage that happens when they do that, it keeps going higher and higher and higher. And this is important, the solar power station. Why solar power station is one of the most important buildings in it. Because due to solar power station, Val has a huge pressure and they have to keep flipping every single time that they flip a building. And if they don't, what ends up happening is that they end up being able to lose points every time that they completely control a building. And for one alliance, it's 1 minute. For another alliance, it's three. Actually, 1:30 and three. You can imagine how much pressure that is, because you only have time to instantly launch a rally in the control time for that. And if it's not full, it's not full, and it's GG. Looks like they were able to flip again. Hi, Kalatan. It's a fierce fight here in Treatment Center 1. I think we got the top screen for where the fight actually is, because the entire rest of the match they're being dominated. But this match is actually where they're putting some fight back, so this is a great spot to keep watching. Oh, I'm not playing Voltaire, I'm actually only casting this. Seems like XXX is starting a bunch of rallies. Very shortly, in around 5 minutes, we're going to start to see the gathering spots, and when we get the gathering spots, we are going to start seeing more thin out of the players. Because right now, everyone is fighting for buildings. Whenever you have more the gathering spots, the joiners are going to have more trouble joining rallies, and this is going to keep putting pressure in everyone to perform properly. Top building was flipped, there's some water in the top building, but they lost control for this building, which means that even if they do get some water in the top, it was not worth it for the extra points that they're getting in here. I By they, I mean VAL. Every time that you control a building, as mentioned, you get the points that are on top of the building. As everything in SOS, not all descriptions are it what it seems to be. The score that you get for first control, actually you get for every single control in the building. Seems like we have some people from XXX Alliance on chat. There is a delay, so even if you try to pass information, by the way, you're not gonna be able to because the delay is roughly 3 minutes. I just double checked, the delay exists. This is a slaughter! She made it for the water tanks to come through. There's still a slight mathematical chance that XXX can turn this over, although, quite frankly, I doubt that's going to happen. I'm not necessarily playing favorites in this specific, it's just that looking at the numbers is really rough. Looks like both sides activated cannons right now. And they are putting pressure in water processing plant 4, probably to try to gather some of the water. I believe it's a little bit too early to try to flip buildings for water, but... A lot of people are going to start going together in 1 minute. And this means that we're going to put a lot more pressure at that moment. So if I was XXX and I wanted to do that specifically, I would have held up for one more minute. And now is when the water tanks show up. It shows 3 water tanks in every quarter of the map. So only one player can probably send a few marches together. And in some cases, it's not going to be usually necessary to relocate. Although relocating gives you advantage on trying to control those nodes. Which is probably why the P9 relocated there to try to gather some points out of the buildings, out of the gathering nodes. You can try doing it, there's a 3 minute delay. The only thing is that you're gonna accomplish by doing this is usually making sure that I do a bigger delay. This is actually so interesting. Not only they're still controlling most of the buildings, but they're actually pushing back and also the gathering nodes. This is a very good match. to watch how much how efficient VAL is impressive. Processing plant was flipped. We're gonna see if they can hold them. Is if it's not possible to hold them again, flipping is a bad idea if you can't hold the building. If I were at, was XXX right now and I had to flip a building to put pressure, I'd go for solar. I'd flip solar and then I would try to take buildings in any position in here. This is what personally I'd do because not holding solar would put a lot more pressure in VAL to actually fight for the buildings. So even if it costs some extra relocators, that would actually do something that would do some interesting dynamics in the match. But as it is right now, going to flip other buildings that are not solar is a bad, bad move. But since they're listening to my chat, to my stream in chat, if they are going to try to flip solar, we'll see in 3 minutes from now if they're gonna take my advice. In 6 minutes, more free nodes show up. And then we're gonna have even more interesting fights in gathering nodes, because then it's 6 nodes per quarter, per position. And then this, yes, will put pressure enough for people to actually move their settlements. Looks like Casper is already moving ahead of time to kick them out. Seems like Casper's stats are a little bit higher, so he is going to be able to dominate those nodes here. At least one of them. What do you mean I wouldn't? That's actually what I would do. If you want, they can even go with Tor and discuss what they could have done, even though they are a superior force in here, to at least disrupt you. I do think you're playing decently well, but I do think that the lack of pressure in solar actually surprises me. You're fighting back Tooth and Nail and Inch in every single place that they can look at. Like, using the cannon right now in that area that is an area that you're fighting for the gathering nodes is a good idea. Taking fillers doesn't accomplish that much, especially because you can get all your troops back. In case you didn't know, there is a way for you to get your troops back without speed-ups. The problem is that most alliances do not know how to execute that, but VAL actually does. So worst case scenario, they can just refill all their players with their troops without using the speed-ups, using the tactic that I mentioned. And And then you lost a lot of troops from your rat leads out of for nothing. Interesting that they're actually basically doing a recall when attack marches based in what they want to go. This is actually fun to watch. Every single second in the water tanks matter. That's why there's so much fight, because water tanks are different than most buildings. Because in those buildings, you usually have to have a control time. In water tanks, you start collecting as soon as you get there. And this is why water tanks tend to be a good way to get points, let's say, in a shorter time. And you have a lot more pressure to keep controlling them or to not let the opponent get in control than in the other buildings. Don't get me wrong, the water on the top of the buildings, plus the fact that if they control, they get extra points, is a lot of pressure. But if they do take the buildings, at least you can recover the water, and you can actually control, avoid the control. So you can deny them points by doing that. In the tanks, whatever, however, if you're not close to them to deny them the points, they're gonna still crawl back every single difference that they can with those points. Both are equally important for different reasons, and they have different ways for you to fight them. Which is why, usually at the minute 26 minute mark, which is what is coming right now, you have a lot of the joiners relocating to those places, because when you do relocate to those places, you actually have to have someone else relocate there, or else, regardless of their stats, they cannot fight back. Unless they're using an insane amount of speeds. Which would be a waste, honestly. Those speeds are much better used to join the rallies and while you use your other marches to fight for the nodes. Looks like one of the treatment centers was flipped. Let's see if XXX can hold, or it's gonna be flipped back during the control time. Now we have more nodes to fight for. As mentioned, at the 26 minute mark, that's when the nodes show up. And this is gonna put a lot more pressure and a lot more fun in nodes. As you can see, there's a lot more joiners in there. And this makes sure that the buildings have a lot more pressure in them with the rally leads having less fillers. And a lot of the water tanks are coming right now to fight for. Looks like Casper is really speeding up to try to bounce them off that direction. Casper is fighting like five different people in the water nuts. Way to go, Casper! Looks like VAL let go of one of the buildings and not fighting for them. Or at least I do not see any rallies going there in this video. We'll see. That being said, this match is probably won. It's actually impressive that they keep fighting to the end to get the most amount of points that they can get. Minute mark. They already flipped the building back. My bad. Seemed like they were actually still going to fight for that building. I wish I could actually have a spectator mode where I could see especially the map. I wanted to know how many nodes are being gathered by each team and where. I can assume as they control and they have 1920, now 2160, how many nodes they have. So XXX currently have 9 nodes, 10. Because they don't hold any buildings, so you can basically do the math for that. But it seems like they're putting most of their pressures in there and trying to get rid of their joiners. It's interesting to see how many nodes Casper can try to fight back, even if he's not close to all of them. It takes a bunch of their joiners just to keep Casper in check with this. Casper is a P9, keep that in mind. A very chunky P9, but still a P9. Looks like Casper has his cannon activated as well. I do not know how much time he has for the cannon, but I'm gonna assume it is in 15 minutes. He activated not long ago. I believe it was 5 minutes ago, so he should have for the last wave, which comes in now in a few minutes. Which is gonna put even more pressure in the other team. Now that we're gonna get in 15 seconds, that's why I'm a little bit quiet, we're gonna get in 15 seconds, the new nodes, the dynamic is gonna change a little bit again. There you go, more nodes coming through at the 16 minute mark. Seems like finally they tried to push back for solar. Yes, Lord Gridstar, as I mentioned, every time that you do control a building, you get the first time bonuses control. As a few things in SOS, the descriptions are not what it seems they are. And sorry for the delay in response, because there's a 3 minute delay. As you can see, some people from XXX are in chat right now, so say hi to them. So it wouldn't be fair for the match, and the match wouldn't be even if they were able to go in real time and see what they were doing. So right now, the way that we're doing things is to actually be more fair and give a 3 minute delay time, which is enough to be annoying for you guys, but it's still watchable, and enough to give a decent advantage to Val, but not like it was not streaming. So it's a common, it's a good compromise in how things are. At this rate, Vow is probably gonna hold close to 500,000 points in this. Looks like they bounce off the center right now. And they were able to balance munitions and get some water from it. Looks like XXX is trying to fight for as many points as they can get in this, at this part of the match. They're finally fighting for solar and munitions. Looks like middle was bounced. Let's see who is gonna get in water. Seems like a lot of XXX is going really hard to get some of this water. Water puddle seems to be the most efficient place for score for XXX right now. I'd say at least half of their points were from puddles. Seems like they're coming for water plant too. Few hits from VAL are bouncing from the center. I wonder if it's gonna bug before. Like before and have like a giant building. Yes, this is live. That being said, even though this is live, it's that there is a 3 minute delay. Everything in SOS, Gridstar, beat me, beat from anyone else. Don't take their word for it, test it. Looks like Maxi Crazy Boy is gonna be fighting for those 3 nodes. And right now, XXX is only controlling 2 nodes. But they are fighting for the center. Seems like participation is something that is affecting both teams. VAL said to me before the match that they didn't have 2 of the red elites. It seems that they're working with some reservists, but XXX is missing 2 players. Probably they have a bunch of players that couldn't come today as well. Which is kind of sad, as the match was already in Fridays, which people took their days off, and was moved up to Monday. It's water! Get the waters, puddles, puddles, puddles! They're pushing a lot in that building. Schneiser basically teleported to try to counter the Solus. Even if it can't be stopped, that they are gonna basically reset the buildings, they can at least burn the player. If done properly, we'll see if it's possible for Schneiser to burn them. And the relocation there from Mabu was on point. Looks like I was a little bit off the mark with the 500,000 points. That being said, it's gonna be very close if it keeps like this. The bigger the building gets, the harder it is to play. So it's basically the game giving you a new challenge difficulty, Genzo. The buildings are becoming bigger and bigger. Looks like Dame control the center. So 6 minutes, they're gonna go for 4:30. If no other building is flipped for water, we're gonna be very close to 500,000. This is not Reservoir Raid Premier, this is the Reservoir League. Looks like a few hits bounce from munitions. A few also bounce from top right. A few buildings are flipping, not a lot, but specifically solar, even if you can't see flipped, and they even control solar at the moment, and munitions. Authentic SOS experience, Genzo, I hope that explains. That phrase says more than anything else I could say to explain. You can deduce the rest. The last final 3 minutes, seems like a lot of things are flipping in terms of points. Sadly, the dream of 500,000 is not gonna happen in this match. All right. Seems like our glorious Kakashi Abukaleo is trying to hold a building from a few hits. Are they going to bounce? Seems like they did bounce. Control do not matter anymore because they're not gonna get control before the match ends. Still a great score, 470,000 roughly for Val. No more nodes to fight for from what it seems from the 6,000 points. No buildings being held anymore by any of the teams, for the red team. At this point, if I was XXX, I would basically just have my fun. Seconds to go. And GG.